The Wall Street Journal columnist Kim Strassel and Fox News contributor Tammy Bruce. All right, Pam, let's look at this. And let's put your legal hat on, your AG hat on. Okay, so we have, on the issue of top secret classified information, we have one system of justice. Then we have this whole other problem that we were discussing earlier, and that has to do with the Biden family, the $1 billion withheld until the prosecutor is fired and the son continues to get enriched for something he has no experience in. I do believe at some point this is now going, that story will make it into the political bloodstream, and it may be the dominoes that now begin to fall where Democrats push Joe Biden out. Your thoughts?
I wholeheartedly agree, Sean. And as you articulately laid out already, that this will be a sweeping investigation of the Biden family and perhaps RICO charges where they would be appropriately filed. Something else that's going to happen, Sean, is when Republicans take back the White House, and we will be back in there in 18 months or less, you know what's going to happen? The Department of Justice, the prosecutors will be prosecuted, the bad ones. The investigators will be investigated because the deep state, last term for President Trump, they were hiding in the shadows. But now they have a spotlight on them, and they can all be investigated, and the House needs to be cleaned out because now we know who most of them are. There's a record of it, and we can clean House next term. And that's what has to happen.
Tammy, let's get your take.
Well, you know, I appreciate Marco Rubio's attitude about worrying about this is going to be, in a way, a tit for tat. But let's look at how this started. You know, this particular environment and the attacks on Donald Trump did not suddenly just arise, you know, out of a unicorn and rainbow world where everything was just fine. We've seen this kind of behavior for generations coming out of Washington. So, you know, think about the IRS, the Tea Party, Lois Lerner, the fact that nothing happened effectively to people like Comey and others who did the Russia dossier hoax. You know, they go on, they make millions of dollars, they write books, and they tiptoe through the freaking tulips here. So, of course, it ends up with weaponizing justice in the open, going after a political opponent, because nothing will happen to them. This kind of behavior is learned behavior. It is rewarded behavior, and it has been going on for decades. Marco Rubio knows this, so the worry is not what's going to happen after this, and isn't that going to be awful? In fact, as Pam has noted, this is our opportunity to actually make a difference, to change what it is that's gone on in Washington, and not just anybody is going to do it. It's going to take a Donald Trump for another term because this idea of, you know, holding Washington accountable is anathema to anyone who wants to go to the parties and, you know, be invited to the White House and not have the media, the drive-by media, hate them. So this is key. And I think Senator Rubio needs to look in the larger context of how did this happen and what are we going to do to fix it, which is going to take, you know, repercussions for the people who put this on us.
You know, and Kimberly, let me get to you on this because I'll use Tammy's phrase, tiptoe through the tulips. Yeah, they seem, you know, totally, completely carefree. I mean, the people involved in implementing this two-tier system of justice, they have this fearless arrogance about them that this is just, you know, the way things are going to be, whether the American people like it or not. They've got to know in the back of their mind somewhere, if they have a conscience or a soul, what they're doing is wrong, that they're treating one group of people one way and another group of people the other way.
Right. And they also have to worry. They have to understand what they are unleashing here, too. I mean, look, I don't think it's any coincidence that one of the reasons that Hunter Biden's entire plea deal fell apart is because they tried to stick an immunity clause in there to make sure that nobody could go after him over all the shenanigans that went into the first deal if the Department of Justice changed. And, you know, look, we do want to have an honest standard of justice, one standard of justice for all. But I do understand Marco Rubio's fear here, too, that we are crossing some sort of line, okay? I mean, that's one thing, the Department of Justice and its politicization. But what happened in Georgia, this really is a new ballgame. We've long had a standard that, you know, if you were a federal politician accused of some sort of serious crime, well, maybe the Department of Justice would get involved. There are thousands of prosecutors, Sean, across this country, at the state and local level, that if the new standard is anyone can go after a federal official on the most stretched of racketeering charges, I mean, this is a very scary new place.
Yeah. All right. Exit question, I'll ask all of you the same one. Pam, I'll start with you. And it's very simple. Is with all that we know about Joe Biden and Hunter Biden and, you know, the money they're making from countries like China and Russia and Romania and Kazakhstan and Ukraine, and Joe leveraging the $1 billion and Hunter getting paid and no experience and he's addicted to drugs, will anything ultimately happen to Joe and Hunter Biden regarding these issues? What is your prediction, Pam?
When we have a new administration, absolutely, Sean, it has to. Joe Biden, we now know, had three aliases. They had 19 shell corporations set up. That is a criminal investigation that must be open.
But Alan Dershowitz said
Congress is going to do a good job.
Alan Dershowitz said Congress can appoint a special counsel, can they?
They can. Congress absolutely can. They have subpoena power, but nothing is going to be done to be prosecuted. They do not have prosecutorial power, investigative power, until 18 months when Donald Trump is back in office. And I think that's what Marco was referring to, frankly.
Tammy, same question.
Well, I believe that only if Donald Trump is elected, there will be justice and there will be genuine investigations, as we've seen, as I've mentioned. It's been a long time that Republicans have had power. It's gone back and forth. And we haven't seen anything significant happen to the level of corruption that's in Washington, D.C. So I don't think it's going to be just any GOP president. I think we're going to have to be looking at least to get the ball rolling four more years of Donald Trump.
Kimberly, same exit question.
You know, we're talking a lot about legal issues, which are important. I want to look at this in a slightly different way, which is that there's another power, the power of the people, to punish politicians via elections. Why did Joe Biden work so hard and his team to make sure we couldn't find out what was going on in Hunter Biden's laptop, et cetera, prior to the last presidential election? Because he feared that it would be enough to make sure that he was not elected. We're going to have these House investigations. And aside from the Department of Justice and what comes down the road, the American people are going to have the ability to render their own punishment on Joe Biden if it turns out he's been untruthful about what went on with his son.
All right. Pam, Tammy, Kimberly, thank you all. Appreciate it. Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it.